Hi, I'm Matt from eSpares. In this video, I'll be showing you how to diagnose electrical problems in pressure washers. Pressure washers can be found in many households, but can suffer from common problems. If your pressure washer is dead, trips the fuse board or electrics in your home, or stalls, this video will help you diagnose that problem and therefore repair it. Safety first, always unplug an appliance before carrying out any work. Pressure washers can also be subject to pump problems, but you can see me diagnose and repair those problems in other eSpares videos. I will be testing several electrical items within the pressure washer. For that, I'll be needing a multimeter. So if your pressure washer does not start, the first thing to check is the fuse. And the reading you're looking for is the same as connecting the two probes of the multimeter together. As you can see, this fuse is fine. Next thing I need to do is to access the electrical items inside the pressure washer. I need to remove the two halves of the case by undoing the screws that hold it together. With the screws removed, I can now separate the two halves of the case, release this pipe here for ease of access, and here we see the motor assembly. Remove that from the case, and now I need to separate the two halves of the motor assembly case. Just use a screwdriver to help remove these clips. And then same on the other side. The first thing I'm going to check is the whole of the circuit. So I'm going to put one probe on the neutral of the plug and one on the live. If you see, the reading has not changed on the multimeter. So there is a break somewhere in the circuit. So now I'm going to check from the plug up to the switch through the cable. So keep one probe on the neutral of the plug to the neutral wire on the switch. Now we can see the reading is very low resistance, so we have continuity. Now I'm going to check the same with the live. So one probe on the live on the plug to the live on the switch. Again, very low resistance, no problems there. So now I'm going to check from the switch to the motor. So one probe on the live on the switch to the live on the motor. Again, low reading, so no problem from the switch to the motor. Let's do the same with the neutral. Very low resistance. So let's check now across the motor. There we can see a very high reading, so there is a problem with the motor. Some motors, like the one on this K5 Compact, will feature a capacitor. If you turn your pressure washer on and the motor stops, or it makes a loud buzzing noise, or it buzzes continuously, suspect and examine the capacitor. You'll notice bulge marks on the capacitor or burn marks, a blackening on it. If the pressure washer trips the fuse board or blows the electrics in your home, make sure there's no water in the switch or the other electrical items, and again, examine the capacitor if your model carries one. It's also a good idea to measure the resistance across the plug. So put one probe of your multimeter on the live pin and one on the neutral. And you're looking for a reading of between 5 and 12 ohms. So there we have it, diagnosing common electrical problems on a pressure washer. Spares and accessories for pressure washers, as well as all other household appliances, can be found on the eSpares website. Thanks for watching.